Students, in this lecture, I'm going to discuss a relationship between lambda equivalent and k. What is lambda equivalent? It is the conductance of 1 gram equivalent of electrolytes. Is that clear? So whenever we have 1 gram equivalent, then the conductance of 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte is known as equivalent conductance. Is that clear? And what is K? K is specific conductance represented by kappa. That is the conductance of 1 cm³ of the solution of that electrolyte. Now, what is the relationship between them? In order to get that relationship, let us say we have a 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte in a cube whose volume is 1 cm³. Okay, now 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte is present in a solution whose volume is 1 cm³. So it means we have 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte. Its conductance is equivalent conductance. Since this is 1 cm³, I may call this as specific conductance. It means in this case, conductance of solution is equal to equivalent conductance is equal to specific conductance. Now, in the second case, I dilute this solution. Say I have volume of solution is 4 cm³. You may assume it to be 10, anything. Fine. Now, I have solution whose volume is 4 cm³ and 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte is present in that. Since 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte is present in the solution, its conductance is still equal to equivalent conductance because the whole solution is containing 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte. Is that clear? But volume is 4 cm³. So what about specific conductance? Conductance of 1 cm³ is known as specific conductance. Therefore, can I write lambda equivalent is equal to K into 4? This is K into 4 cm³. Now, conductance of 1 cm³ is what? K. So, if I have 10 cm³ of solution containing 1 gram equivalent, then lambda equivalent will be equal to K into 10 cm³. And 1 cm³ conductance of 1 cm³ solution is K. It means final result will come out to be lambda equivalent is equal to K into V. So this is a relationship between lambda equivalent and K. And what is V? We must know this term. This is volume of solution containing one gram equivalent of electrolyte. I hope so. This term is clear. So lambda equivalent is equal to K into V. V is the volume which is containing 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte. Now exactly we can relate lambda equivalent and lambda m. What is the difference between them? In lambda equivalent, we take 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte dissolved in V centimeter cube of solution. When the distance between electrode is 1 centimeter and area is so large that whole of the solution is contained between them. And what about lambda m? We simply consider 1 mole instead of 1 gram equivalent. Is that clear? Now we know their expressions. Lambda equivalent is equal to K into 1000 by N, where N stands for normality. And lambda m is K into 1000 by m. If I divide molar conductance by equivalent conductance, definitely what I get, K is specific conductance, conductance of 1 cm³ of solution. This will cancel out and we get a ratio of n by m. Now what is n? Normality, which is valency multiplied by molarity. So molarity will cancel out, we get valency. It means lambda m is equal to A times lambda equivalent. Now in order to understand, I take one example that aluminium sulfate dissociates as 2 aluminium ion plus 3 sulfate ions. Now what is its factor or valency? This is 2 multiplied by 3. This is 6. And here 3 multiplied by 2, that remains the same. 6. It means for aluminium sulfate, lambda m is equal to 6 times lambda equivalent. Exactly, if I take a general term, A3B4, this dissociates as 3A4 positive plus 4B3 negative. Now what is A? A is 12. It means lambda m is equal to 12 times lambda equivalent. So these two relationships are very important for your competition as well as for your plus 2 level. Now, second topic of my 7th lecture is variation of conductance and specific conductance with dilution. Now, we know that conductance is ease to the flow of charge. More the number of ions, definitely more is the conductance of the solution. So when we dilute a solution, number of ions will increase if we have weak electrolyte, because dissociation is not complete in case of weak electrolyte, and dissociation or ionization increases with dilution in case of weak electrolyte. So when we dilute a solution of weak electrolyte, number of ions will increase. Since number of ions is increasing, therefore conductance will definitely increase. If I take a case of strong electrolyte, in which dissociation is always complete at all concentration, it means number of ions are not going to play their role. With dilution, the interactions between the ions will decrease, means their restrictions, the movement restriction of ions, the restriction was because of interaction, that restriction will decrease. That is why ions can move freely. So if we consider conductance of solutions, that will increase in case of weak electrolyte as well as in case of strong electrolyte. But that increase is quite prominent, visible in case of weak electrolyte, because number of ions are increasing with dilution. But in case of strong electrolyte, number of ions are not increasing, but their intermolecular interactions are decreasing. That is why they can move freely. So conductance will increase. Is that clear? With dilution in case of strong electrolyte also. Now the second part is specific conductance. Specific conductance is the conductance of unit cube of a material. Now we think if conductance is increasing, it means definitely specific conductance is also increasing. This is not the case. Specific conductance is decreasing with dilution. Now, in order to explain that, let us take this beaker. In this case, I have solution of acetic acid. Okay, so there are few ions of acetate and hydronium ion. Let us suppose we dilute it. With dilution, what will happen? Acetic acid is a weak electrolyte, number of ions will increase. So in the whole beaker, total number of ions will increase. But if we consider number of ions per unit cube, which is specific conductance, so number of ions per unit cube will decrease. Since number of ions per cube is decreasing, therefore your specific conductance of solution will decrease with dilution. So, nutshell, if I want to sum up that part, conductance will increase in case of weak electrolyte as well as in case of strong electrolyte. but that effect is quite more in case of weak electrolyte dilution because number of ions are increasing. Specific conductance, either case of weak electrolyte or strong electrolyte, specific conductance will decrease because we consider number of ions per centimeter cube. Since number of ions per centimeter cube is decreasing, so specific conductance is decreasing.